Hey y'all, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back to Shanice Renee. Okay, so I know it's been a minute, but I'm back now. So this is what we're gonna get into. So just recently, it's been like a list going around, a top 50 rapper list. Some have been greatest of all time and whatnot. Most of those I didn't agree with, but I'm here to set the record straight. I mean, and you know, if you agree with me, let me know. If you don't agree with me, let me know. And you can just like, comment, and subscribe to this video. Let me know how you feel, okay? So let's get started. Number one on my list is, of course, none other than Tupac himself. He's one of the greatest of all time. Not only did he rap, but I mean, he starred in movies and everything else too before his life was short-lived. So yeah, that's, you know, one of the reasons why he's number one. And of course, number two have to be Biggie himself. I mean, it's Biggie, like who cannot bop to Biggie? Okay, and number three have to be none other than Jay-Z himself. I mean, not only does he rap, which of course he doesn't really rap like that now, but also, I mean, the man is an entrepreneur. I mean, what doesn't he have? I mean, he has like his own clubs, his own restaurants. So of course he's like getting checks on top of checks on top of his own record label. So I mean, you know, rapping is good and everything, but you gotta have some other stream of income because this thing is not gonna be forever. So it's just smart to get in your own investment, your own business, and make your money. Get those coins. So number four is gonna be, of course, Nas. Number five, I think is, I mean, you can't even argue with this. Andre 3000. Number six. Now, number six, on this one, I had to split it evenly. I know that's not normal, but I had to do it like that. So for number six, I got Kendrick Lamar and J. Cole. I couldn't choose between the two. I couldn't put one on top of the other. I love them equally both. Kendrick Lamar has been ghost a little bit lately, but you know, that's cool or whatever. But J. Cole has been popping out with some hits and whatnot. So, you know, I'll rock with both of them. Number seven, Lil Wayne. How can he not be on the greatest rapper list of all time? How can you not be on the top 50 rappers list? Come on, it's Lil Wayne. Like, I don't care what nobody says, you know, before the drugs, all this and that. It's Lil Wayne. Y'all been bopping to his, come on. Carter 1, Carter 2, Carter 3, Carter 4 and 5. Okay, like, come on. Anyway, on to the next. And of course there would not be a Drake if it wasn't for a Lil Wayne. Oh, he's still out here making these hits and whatnot. You can't even be mad at him. And of course, I had to put him on this list, T.I. And after T.I., we have Big Sean. Big Sean, like, I have always loved Big Sean. He's always been in my top five. I don't care. He even popped out with a single again. Y'all, I love that song. The video is even better. I love that song. And hailing all the way from Philly, Meek Mill. Meek Mill is for sure has to be on the list. And next we have Nicki Minaj. I had to put a female in there. You can't tell me that she wasn't bopping to Itty Bitty Piggy. That was a bop back then. I mean, I can still bop to it. Like, yeah, Nicki Minaj and Megatron. Okay. And after Nicki Minaj, even though they can't get along, Cardi B. I can get lit the Cardi B, okay? Like, I was just having this talk with somebody and I was like, I don't understand why Lil Durk is not, like, you know, really popping like that. Like, he's popping, or at least in my eyes he is. But I feel like everybody is just starting to know his name and whatnot. But like, why isn't he really out there like that? Like, he should be. Like, I feel like he's not where he's at. And I mean, I feel like he got the talent to be where he need to be. But I don't know. I don't know what it is, but yeah, anyway. And after Lil Durk, of course, the baby. You know, the baby really been putting on for the Carolinas. So I mean, yeah, like, why is he not included in, you know, the top 50 rappers? After the baby, of course, Lil Baby. He's definitely putting on for the A. Like, Lil Baby be dropping them hits, for real, for real. You can't have Lil Baby without Gunna, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, they both putting on and whatnot. And of course, what's a list without Future Hendrix? You know, that astronaut music. Yeah, Future, he's been putting on. After Future, we have Moneybagg Yo. Moneybagg Yo, cool or whatever. I can vibe to his music. And then we have 21 Savage. Of course, after 21 Savage, we got Yo Gotti. Yes, Yo Gotti. Yo Gotti, cool. So I don't know how many people will feel about this next rapper, but Roddy Ricch, like, I could listen to Roddy Ricch probably all day. Like, Roddy Ricch, he got that sound. Like, yeah, I can vibe to his music, for real, for real. Yeah, so why not? Like, he's definitely one of those up-and-comer, one of those rising artists. Of course, he was on a XXL freshman cast her roster or whatever. So I mean, yeah. And after Roddy Ricch, we gotta have YNW Melly, okay? Free Melly, all that. Yeah, like Melly, yeah. I mean, you know, need to get back out and do this music. Cause Melly. Okay, and of course after YNW Melly, we got YG repping for the West Side. YG cool. And then next we have 50 Cent, of course, the bill collector himself. 50 been popping, you know. Anyway, but yeah, 50 Cent, you know what I'm saying? I was a 50 fan back in the day. And then next, of course, The Game, the one I like to say who 50 put out there anyway. I don't think we would know who The Game was without 50 Cent. So, yeah. And then, of course, I didn't want to put them separately, but of course, Migos, the Migos. That's Offset, Quavo, and Takeoff. Collectively as one, they pop. And individually, they pop. We can see for ourselves. Of course, the H-Town hottie herself, Meg Thee Stallion. Yes, my girl. You already know she repping H-Town and whatnot. Meg, okay? I feel like she's that female rapper who's really getting all of the females together. Like, she can vibe with any and everybody. And I think that's what's so cool about her. Like, you don't see any female rapper who've ever gotten along with everyone else. Next is Jid. I think that's how you pronounce his name. J-I-D. Of course, he's with the Dreamville label with J. Cole. He pops, for real. He pops. And then, of course, A Boogie with the Hoodie. Now, you can't tell me that you was not rapping that I still think about you. Yeah, you can't tell me you was rapping that. Now, you can't tell me you was singing along with him. You can't tell me you did not feel his pain, because I think we all did, okay? But yeah, of course, the late, the great Nipsey Hussle. Yes, much love to Nipsey Hussle. Had to put that in there. Of course, I had to do YFN Lucci. He had a lot of hits. I feel like he has that voice. Of course, Travis Scott puts on a show, so I've been told. I always said that I wanted to go and see a concert of his because I feel like he be out there. And then next we have Jeezy. I feel like Jeezy put on, as he said, he put on for his city, and I feel like he did that. Okay, and then next we have Rick Ross. Matter of fact, Rick Ross just put out his latest album, Port of Miami, too. And, you know, I'm currently listening to that, so I don't have an opinion on that yet. But, yeah, y'all go listen to that. Tell me what you think. Then, of course, Wale. I love Wale. Wale has just recently said that he is the greatest of all time. And, I mean, I don't even have an argument with that. Like, I don't have an argument for that. I feel like Wale, he doesn't get the credit that he deserves. Like, Wale is like, you know, like that little poetic person who can put those words together and whatnot. And I feel like people don't give him his credit. So, yeah, I mean, and why not feel like that with your work of art? Everybody should feel like that. So, I mean, why not? And you know we can't have a rapper's list without 2 Chainz, okay? Yes, I mean, 2 Chainz, Titty Boy, whatever you want to call him, play a circle. You know who I'm talking about, 2 Chainz. So next we have King Von, which is one of Lil Durk's artists. I'm telling you, if you haven't heard him yet, you need to go listen right now, okay? Like, I feel like he's the next big thing. And I'm not just saying that because he's one of Lil Durk's artists, but for real, the kid, he has talent, okay? And I'm talking raw, natural talent. Go check him out. And then next on the list is Big Crit. I feel like he's one of the most lyrical rappers out there. He's been dropping projects and whatnot every now and then. But yeah, check out his latest stuff. And next we have T Grizzly, okay, Detroit player, T Grizzly, y'all know him, First Day Out, that's what y'all mainly know him from, but he's had some bangers since then, so check him out. Then next, you know, I had to get another female rapper in there, Tokyo Jets, okay, she can go with the best of them, I'm telling you. She can probably out-rap any rapper out there, I'm telling you, like, and she could freestyle, for real. She got bars. Next, of course, we got our big uncle Snoop Dogg. I had to put him on there. Snoop been rapping since Biggie and Pac. Okay, I don't know how y'all gonna feel about this, but I don't really care. It's my list anyway. So I had to put I don't even know how to pronounce her name. Saweetie, whatever. You know, that's my type. Hey, that's my type. Yeah, I had to put it on there. I like that song. I could, yeah. Anyway, next we have on the list, Don't judge me. But yeah, I did put Chris Brown on the list. Have y'all not heard Chris Brown rap? Chris Brown can go toe-to-toe with most of these rappers. No lie. Yeah, Chris Brown can rap, okay? I know he's a singer and all that, but Chris Brown can rap. I had to put Childish Gambino on there. Yes. Childish Gambino, Donald Glover, whatever you want to call him. I like him. Of course, you have to have your vanilla in all of this chocolate. Eminem, Slim Shady, please stand up, okay? Yeah, he's paved the way, so. Next we have, I don't even know if a lot of people may know this person, but Killer Mike. He's not only a rapper, but he's an activist. Next we have to have Pimp C, an underground king, and of course we can't leave him hanging without his bro, Bun B, okay? Pimp C, Bun B. All right, underground kings, like, for real, for real. Some great rappers. Okay, and next we have to have the baddest chick in the game, Trina, okay? Yeah, you know, repping that 305 all the way from Miami, live, Dade County, okay? Okay, now I know that concludes the 50 rappers list, but I had to add just one or two more in there. You know, I wasn't satisfied. I feel like some more people needed some more recognition. So next we have Cash Doll, okay, coming from Detroit. And last but not least, I almost left him off this list. I don't know why. I think I just forgot about him. Like, I was like, okay, yeah, I'm gonna put him on the list. But then when I was making the list, I forgot. So anyway, yeah, I gotta have Kanye West. Even after these little situations he's been going through and these little, you know, things he's been getting himself in too, you know, but he still was a great rapper way before the Kardashians, before they got into his life. You know, college dropout. Yeah, you know, all of that. So of course he has to be included. So yeah, so that concludes the top 50 rappers list. Yeah, let me know what y'all think. Let me know if you agree with some of the rappers that I said. Let me know if you disagree. Let me know what you think. Just like, comment, and subscribe. You already know what to do. Yeah, thank you for tuning in to Shanice Renee. But like I said, like, comment, subscribe, and I hope y'all enjoy. But yeah, as always, follow me on my social media, Twitter at underscore I'm Shanice, Instagram at underscore I'm Shanice, and Snapchat, of course, ShaniceD328. Thank you guys.